Hey River Sharks fans, it's time for another edition of Shark Splash. I'm Tyler Olsson here with Josh Towers. Very welcomed addition to the starting rotation, signed in early June, and he's been terrific ever since coming on. Josh, you've got 8 years of Major League experience. What does that mean as far as teaching these other guys here that maybe haven't reached the big leagues before? What can you teach them as a starting pitcher?
I mean, there's a lot, obviously, I can teach. Experience is something that, you know, obviously, it's valuable. There's a lot of things that I've done, I've been through, that I can teach, but it's finding somebody who wants to receive what you're trying to give out, and if you're willing to give it out at the same time, you know what I'm saying? We talk a lot, though. I think just in general, like if you were my throwing partner, we talk a lot about pitching and stuff like that, and I think that's where we tend to get better with each other.
Do you welcome the opportunity to be a leader for these guys? Are you more of a vocal guy with the starting pitchers, even the bullpen guys, or are you kind of just lead by example type deal?
If I had to choose out of those two, I'd say more lead by example. I'm not the most vocal guy in the world. When it comes to that, the rah-rah, hey, let's get together, let's do this stuff type. I'd rather just do my business on the field and hopefully that leads. And then, like I said, if we're working together on a daily basis, then I can be more vocal with you one-on-one. But as far as a big group, I'm not the guy's gonna stand in the middle of the room and grab everybody's attention.
One of your best starts of the season was at Somerset, an 8-inning complete game losing effort. But for me, from the games that I've seen, that was really a turning point, I think, for this rotation. Because up until then, starting pitchers had gone maybe 3-4 innings at a time. That was a big turning point, I think, as an example, as you said, leading by example, showing these guys how to go deep into games. What is the key to staying sharp through all that period of time late into the ballgame?
We like to talk more about one inning at a time, and you can break it down further, one batter, one pitch. It's how much you simplify it. If I look at the whole pitcher, if I look at all nine guys, if I look at their lineup in general, it makes everything tougher. If we just focus on the one batter at a time or the one inning at a time, then we're playing 9 one-inning games.
One of the local fan favorites around here, at least, Roy Halladay for the Philadelphia Phillies. You had an opportunity to play with him in Toronto. What did you learn from him, one of the best pitchers in the world right now?
He is the best in the world. There's nobody better, that's for sure about that. I learned a lot. I don't know how much I took from him, but I learned a lot. We were talking about it earlier. The man's just the hardest worker that I've ever seen, physically, but more mentally. In this game, physically, if you're in it, I don't like to use the word easy, but if you're in the game, everybody basically can get the job done. It's the mental part of the game that makes people better. And he works harder physically, but mentally more than anybody I've ever seen.
Favorite ballpark you've ever had a chance to play in?
Oakland A's.
Coliseum. It's a crazy place.
It's a mess of what it is.
Horns going, flags waving all over the place. Yeah. Favorite city you've ever visited?
Outside of baseball?
You do baseball and outside of baseball.
Outside of baseball, London, England. Inside of baseball, there's so many, but I don't know if you can beat New York. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's just an amazing place.
All right, well, that was this edition of Shark Splash. For Josh Towers, I'm Tyler Olsson. Thanks for tuning in.
All right.